An officer in the Indian Armed Forces inherits glorious heritage and timeless traditions blended perfectly with latest technology in the fields of management, engineering, and medical sciences. Our armed forces offer a golden opportunity to be a part of the world's finest Army, Navy, and Air Force and get trained not only to be an officer but also a gentleman for life. If in case you are a very eager defense aspirant dreaming to join the Indian Military Academy or the Officers Training Academy to be a part of the Indian Army, or to join the Indian Naval Academy to be a part of the Indian Navy, or to join the Air Force Academy to be a part of the Indian Air Force, you have to completely write the Combined Defense Services Examination, which will be conducted for all the graduates of our country. CDS is considered to be the most important sought-after examination by millions of aspirants of our country who are completely writing this examination every year twice, and this is considered to be a very, very strategic examination conducted by the Union Public Service Commission of our country. Hello everyone, and welcome back for another interesting session of the study plans being provided by SSB Crack Exams. I am Hemant, and I'm back here again to discuss with you about the complete detailed study plan regarding the general knowledge paper of the Combined Defense Services Examination regarding the mathematics and the English sections. So in this particular section, I will be discussing with you about the general knowledge paper, which is the second paper after which you write the most important questions, and this paper is considered to be a very, very strategic paper, and for most of the aspirants this question paper is considered to be a very crucial one. So in this particular session, I will discuss with you about how to study the complete general knowledge paper in about 400 days. Remember, this study plan will be for around 400 days, and I will cover most of the most important inputs. Okay, so we cannot cover the complete study plan in around 365 days. So 365 days would be covered if in case you are just an NDA aspirant, because in that case the Indian polity is not very important. But in this particular question paper, subjects like Indian polity and history are considered to be very, very crucial part. So here I will start off and discuss with you about the complete study plan in around 400 days, and how to cover all of these issues. So the complete study plan will be based on 400 days, which clearly indicates that you have around 400 hours of preparation. That means 1 hour on each day you need to spend this particular amount of time. Okay, so if in case you are preparing for the upcoming CDS examination, I highly recommend you to download the Android app. Also, you can even go through the website learn.ssbcrackexams.com and then start off with your favorite CDS courses, wherein which we have already provided to you the most important detailed lecture content, study material, sample practice questions, quizzes, exercises, and also the mock tests that are made taking into consideration the latest exam patterns. You can even follow us on all sorts of social media platforms to keep yourself updated with the most important Indian and international inputs. So I will start off with understanding about the marking system of the CDS question paper. So please remember, CDS general knowledge question paper consists of around 120 questions. Remember, this question paper has around 120 questions, and these 120 questions will be carried for around only 100 marks. Okay, so 120 questions are not for 120 marks. 120 questions are only for 100 marks, which clearly indicates that for each and every particular question, you will be scoring 0.83 marks for every correct answer. And there is also a negative marking, which will be 0.27 marks for every incorrect answer. Okay, so please remember that you will be deducted 0.27 marks for every incorrect answer, and you will be given 0.83 marks for every correct answer. So there is a negative marking. So I urge you that please do not go for the guesses and all the other things, because only answer those questions that you are absolutely sure enough, because only that will make you and will gift you, award you as many good amount of marks as possible. Okay, so I will start off with discussing about the components of the CDS GK question paper, about the syllabus and the subjects that are involved, and then in each and every particular subject I will discuss with you about the previous year's question and answers analysis. Later on I will tell you about the expected number of questions, and thereafter I will discuss with you about the subject wise day wise study plan. That means each and every particular day, on day 1, 2, 3, 4, all the way up to the 400, how many topics that you have to study, what is the topic, how much amount of time you have to study, and what are those important things that you need to focus upon, and how important is that topic. Each and every particular thing I will be discussing in this particular section. Okay, so please stay tuned with me and go through with what all I am trying to give you, and make sure that you keep your eyes and ears open, as attentive as possible, because each and every particular point is very important that I am providing it to you. Okay, so all the inputs that I'm giving you here is regarding after a thorough analysis of all the previous year's questions, about all the complete syllabus of the complete CDS JK question paper, and about all the important doubts and queries that I've received from various other aspirants all across our country. So please make sure that you follow this study plan that I'm giving it to you, if in case you have this amount of ample amount of time. Okay, so the subjects that are involved in the CDS JK question paper, they are physics, chemistry, biology, geography, history, polity, economics, static general knowledge and current affairs, and also the last one will be the defense specific related questions. Okay, so I will start off with the first and foremost subject, and that is physics. If we go through with the physics, since the last 5 years we have to see that the number of questions in the physics is a little bit changing. So it will be maximum number of questions that you can expect every time will be 8, and in the last year in CDS 2 2020 question paper we got around 10 questions. So if we go through this particular trend and analysis, and in the long back in CDS 1 2015, a maximum number of questions, there were 14 questions were asked in the physics. So going through with this particular trend, I would like to give you a detailed expected number of questions. So going through with the expected number of questions in the upcoming CDS examination, you can get 9 to 10 questions, and answering all of them properly, you will be able to score 7.5 to 8.33 marks in out of the 100 marks of the CDS question paper. Okay, so how many marks? For physics, it will be only from 7.5 to 8.33 marks out of these 100 marks in physics. Okay, so clearly it is an indication that it will be around 1/10 or 1/8 of the complete one. So please make sure that you always have a brief knowledge about the physics. And going through, starting off with the syllabus of the physics, our first preference we will be giving with the physics. And on day one, for the first 1 hour, you will be spending time in learning about the physical world and units and measurements. Here you will be also focusing upon the dimensional formulae and various other important issues. Please give a special time in learning about the dimensional formulae, because dimensional formula is that important one that every time in the CDS examination we will be getting. Then going through on days of 2, 3, 4 and 5, 4 days, 4 hours you will be spending in learning about the motion in straight line. While learning about the motion in straight line, please also do learn about the various other aspects regarding the vector, algebra and all the other issues. And then you can also learn about the problems related towards the related velocity, related acceleration and relative acceleration, all these other important inputs regarding the problems with trains and boats and rivers and all. Okay, so going on with the next 4 days, you will be learning about the chapter known as motion in plane, which indicates directly towards the two-dimensional and three-dimensional kinematics. So there you will be learning about the various vector algebraic formulas, and then you will also learn in a very brief detail about various other aspects. And there you will also learn about the parallelogram law, the complete triangular law of the vectors, and there you will also learn about the various problems related towards the plane motion, the projectile motion and all the other ones. Okay, so these 4 days will be related to that. Give a special analysis while you're learning here. Please give a special time while learning about the projectile motion, because projectile motion is very important. While learning about the projectile motion, also do learn about the range of the projectile and also the maximum velocity of the projectile and all. Going through with the next 2 days, on days of 10th and 11th, you will be learning about the laws of motion, that means the Newton's laws of motion, three laws of motion. The next 2 days you will be learning about the formulas related to the work, energy and power, and how are they related towards each other, and how can you express the same formulas using the differentiation and using the integration. And then going through with the next 2 days, you will be learning about the rotational motion, and here you will be learning about the centripetal and centrifugal acceleration and the various physical application of the terms regarding that, which might include the banking of roads and all. Okay, so in days of 16 and 17, you will be learning about gravitation. While learning about gravitation, give special emphasis on the formulas of the Newton's universal law of gravitation. And then on the day of 18, you will have the complete revision of the topics that are given here. Since day one itself, wherein which you are going through with the each and every particular chapter, you will always maintain notes, and please do maintain the proper notes. Always write all the formulas, whether they are easy for you, whether they might be remembered or not remembered, it doesn't even care. You have to write all the formulas as much better as possible, and you will follow the revision. Whenever I told you the revision, you will only follow the notes that you have written. Understanding, you do not have to go through the complete lectures again, or even you do not have to go through the complete book again. Okay, simply you can go through the complete notes and that will be enough, and after having a brief revision you can take a rest on that particular day. Going through on days of 19 and 20, you will be learning about the solid mechanics, and then next 2 days is about the fluid mechanics, and then in the next 3 days you will be learning about the thermodynamics. So these chapters are not very important, but sometimes they might be important. While learning about the solid mechanics, give a special emphasis while learning about the terms related to stress, strain, different kinds of modulus and all. Then while learning about the fluid mechanics, please do learn about the Torricelli's law, Poiseuille's law, and also the various Bernoulli's principle and various principle regarding the fluid mechanics and all. So those will be very important. While learning about the thermodynamics, give special emphasis while learning about the thermodynamic cycles, terms related towards enthalpy, and what are the static variables and dynamic variables and all. DO 26, you will be learning about the kinetic theory of gases, wherein which you will be learning about the RMS velocity, average velocity, and various other terms. And then on DO 27, you will be learning about the complete revision of the topics that I mentioned above. Okay, so all the important formulas and all the other things that you have learned in these 4 days, you will be spending a little bit of time in again revising the complete notes on day of 27. Coming to on day 28, you will be learning about the oscillations, and then using oscillations you will be learning about the different kinds of pendulum and all. So there you will be learning about different types of pendulum and all. Then on days of 29 and 30, you will be learning about the waves and wave optics. While learning about the waves and wave optics, there you will be learning about the Newton's law of octaves and all the other issues. Then in the next 2 days, on days of 31 and 32, you will learn about the revision of the solid mechanics and the waves and wave optics. Okay, then on days of 33, 34 and 35, 3 days, you will be learning about electric charges and fields and current electricity. Please spend time in learning about the complete details regarding the power of that particular electrical circuit, the amount of voltage that is being used, the current that is being passed upon, and the resistivity in that particular circuit, and various other formulas like Wheatstone bridge and all the other issues. You can also learn about the equivalent resistance of resistors and capacitors when they are connected in series or parallel, and all the other detailed issues in all these 3 days. Also, you will also be learning about the most and foremost important thing is, please spend special time in the chapter of electric charges and fields by learning about the electrical resistance and capacitance, and what is the formula of the electrical voltage and output and all the other issues. Okay, then on days of 36, 37 and 38, the next 3 days, you will be learning about the moving charges and magnetism. You will learn about how is electricity and magnetism are associated with each other. You will also learn about the Fleming's right hand, left hand rule and all. We will also learn about the solenoid and toroid and all the other issues. Then you will also learn about different types of magnetism. How can magnetism be improved? What are electromagnets and what are the soft materials and what are the other issues regarding that? You will also learn about the different types of magnets and different types of magnetism like diamagnetism, paramagnetism, ferromagnetism and ferrimagnetism and all. Okay, then on day of 39, you will learn about electromagnetic induction, and while learning about electromagnetic induction, you will learn about the generator and electric motor. On days of 40 and 41, you will have the complete revision of the topics from the electric charges and fields, current electricity, all the way up towards electromagnetic induction. That means days 40 and 41 is fully about electricity and magnetism. Okay, going through with the last and final slide regarding the physics section, you will be learning 2 days of the electromagnetic waves. Please spend special time while learning about electromagnetic waves, because it is very, very important chapter. And please understand, because there are 7 different types of electromagnetic spectrum, and among all of the 7, from top to bottom, or from the increasing of wavelength, what will happen to its frequency, what will happen to its energy, and what will happen to its photon intensity and all the other issues, please do learn about them while learning about electromagnetic waves. Okay, starting off with the optics and optical instruments, in that particular chapter you will learn mostly about the various kinds of the terms known as the focus, power of the lens, what is a diopter, and you will also learn about the various types of mirrors, various types of lenses, and if the complete object is placed at different positions, and where will the image be formed, and all the other terms regarding that. Day 47, 48, 49, one day each, you will be spending time in learning about the photoelectricity, atomic physics and semiconductors. And on the last day, day 50, you will have the revision from electromagnetic waves all the way up towards the semiconductors. So this is the complete sectional plan regarding the physics subject. Okay, so what are you doing, sir? In among 400 days, I have how much time? I have 400 days. So in these 400 days, I am spending 50 days of time only learning about physics. Why I am doing like that? Because physics is is considered to be very, very important subject. Around 8 to 9 questions are coming from the physics every year. So physics, we have to make sure that we need to be a little bit more confident while answering the questions related to this particular subject. Okay, going through with the chemistry is the next subject we are looking upon. So chemistry is a little bit more important when considered with physics and the biology also. So chemistry, number of questions will be more than physics in the case of the CDS examination. And if you see the trends that are being there, that is being shown by this particular bar diagram, in the recent examination CDS 2 2020, there were 13 questions, and the maximum number of questions have come in recent year CDS 2 2019, there were 18 questions from the chemistry section. So this clearly indicates about how chemistry is very important. So going through with this particular trend that is being shown by this bar diagram, I can say that I can expect from around 12 to 14 questions out of these 120 questions, and answering all of these 12 to 14 questions, I will be able to score 10 to 11.66 marks out of these 100 marks. So this clearly indicates that I can score around 1/10 of the marks by answering all of the answers in chemistry. Starting off with the study plan regarding chemistry, I will spend only one day learning about the matter in our surroundings. Is matter around us pure? Structure of the atom, atoms and molecules, and revision from all the topics of matter in our surroundings all the way up towards atoms and molecules. Day 56, I will begin learning about chemical reactions and equations. 2 days, I will give special time in 2 hours learning about acids, bases and salts. 1 day for metals and non-metals. 2 days for carbon compounds. 1 day for classification of elements. And the last, on day of 63, I will have the revision of all the topics that are mentioned here. Going through now with the next day, on day of 64, I will learn about the basic chemistry, states of the matter, atomic structure, advanced chemical bonding, and then we will again have 2 days of revision. Day 71 is of the thermodynamics. Here I can spend a little bit less amount of time because the maximum amount of time regarding thermodynamics I've already spent in learning about the physics section. If you want to go through the thermodynamics section of physics again, you can again go through here. Going through on day of 72, you will learn about solution. 73 is about equilibrium. Today 74 and 75 is about the redox reactions and electrochemistry. 1 day for chemical kinetics, and 1 day in completely having revision from the topics of thermodynamics all the way up towards the chemical reactions. Going through on day of 78, one day I will have in learning about the surface chemistry and metallurgy. 2 days for the term of the complete chapter of hydrogen. 1 day to learn completely about S block and P block elements. 1 day again to learn completely about the D block and F block elements. 1 day to learn about the coordination compounds. And again, we'll have a revision from the surface chemistry all the way up towards the coordination compounds. Going through in detail regarding the other plan, until now we have completely finished up with the physical chemistry and inorganic chemistry. Now our focus will be on organic chemistry. So I'm starting off from day 88. I'm starting my organic chemistry chapter. So 2 days, 88 and 89, I will be learning about the basic organic chemistry. Then comes 1 day each in learning about hydrocarbons, haloarchanes, organic compounds containing oxygen, organic compounds containing nitrogen, and then the revision of all the topics that I mentioned from the basic organic chemistry all the way up towards the nitrogen containing organic compounds. Going through from day 95 to 100, I will be learning about polymers, biomolecules, environmental chemistry, chemistry in everyday life, and miscellaneous chemistry, and then I will have the revision of all of these topics. So how many days I'm giving for chemistry, sir? I'm giving 50 days for chemistry. Okay, so this will be from day of 51 all the way up towards the day of 100. Okay, so 50 days for physics, 50 days for chemistry. Okay, going through now with the next important subject is regarding biology. And if we go through the biology, we have to see that the number of questions in biology is not very, very changing, because if we see the number of questions in biology has been maintaining a very decent trend. So in the recent examination, there were 9 questions that have come up in the CDS 2 2020 examination, and the maximum number of questions have come in CDS 2016, and in the both the years of CDS 2018, there were 11 questions. So completely following up with this particular trend being shown by these bar graphs, I can say that I can expect from around 10 to 11 questions in biology in the upcoming examination, and answering all of them properly, I will be able to score 8.33 to 9.16 marks out of these 100 marks in the upcoming CDS examination. Starting off with the completely subject analysis regarding the biology section, I will have 2 days every time in each and every particular chapter. chapter. I will spend 2 days in learning about that particular chapter, and the chapters that we have to go through, they include biological classification, plant kingdom, animal kingdom, anatomy of flowering plants, transport and nutrition in plants, respiration in plants, reproduction in plants, biomolecules, cell cycle and its division, human digestive system, circulatory system, and going through detail, excretory system, muscular system, nervous system, hormones and integration, human reproductive system, the genes and its inheritance, diseases, microbes in human welfare, ecosystem dynamics, and biodiversity and environment. Okay, so about all the chapters we have covered in just 2 days each. So in the last few days, all the way up towards the day of 150, we will have the complete revision of the topics of the biology. Okay, so what are we doing? We are again spending 50 days of time for biology, sir. Okay, we are again spending 50 days of time for biology. Going through now with the next important subject, we will now start off with the geography section while starting off with the humanities part. So until now, we have completely covered the general sciences, that is physics, chemistry and biology, 50-50 days each. So 150 days are completely covered up to now. Our focus will now be learning about geography, history, Indian polity, economics and the current affairs and static GK and the defense specific related questions. So starting off with the geography one, if we see these bar graphs, we can clearly say that the maximum number of questions have come up in the recent examination only. In CDS 2 2020, 22 questions have come up, which is the maximum among all the years that we have seen until now. And going through with the trend that is being shown up through this particular geography section, we can say that we can expect around 19 to 21 questions in the upcoming CDS examination, and answering all of them properly, you will be able to score 15.83 to 17.5 marks out of these 100 marks. Starting off with the study plan regarding the geography one, I have to say that from day 151, you will learn about the latitude, longitude, time zone, physical features of our country. Again, one day about important streets, one day regarding international boundaries, 3 days in learning about the physical features, study Himalayas, great Gangetic plains, peninsula, plateau, deserts and islands, 1 day in learning about names and information of all the coastal plains, 3 days each in learning about all major rivers and the tributaries, hydropower, thermal and nuclear power projects, location of minerals, major industries and historical cities. Day 167, you will learn about the Green Revolution and various other agricultural practices that are being implemented by our country. 168 is regarding the factors causing pollution, both man-made and natural one. Day 169 and 170, 2 days in learning about the major national parks in India. While doing so, all of these things from major national parks of India, wherever I'm putting a star mark, for all of these star mark ones, please do mention that you use maps. Okay, these maps can be outline maps or these lines, these maps can be political maps, where whatever kind of maps that you are using, please use only maps, because if you use maps, it will be very easy, because in examination they will not simply ask where is Gir National Park located. They will give you a different set of national parks and then they will ask you arrange all of these national parks in the order from north to south. So it is very clear that you also know the national parks, about all the other important ones, and what are they famous for, which particular animals located at what particular one, and where can we find their specific species, and are they endemic species or are they epidemical species, what are they facing as of now. So all the other details regarding that you will learn by going through with the national parks of our country. Also, while going through in detail, you will also spend 1 day in learning about the biodiversity hotspots in our country, in UNESCO World Heritage Sites, major environmental and industrial summits across the world, 3 days completely in learning about the origins and the interior of the earth and atmosphere. This is completely regarding the astrophysics. Okay, this is completely astrophysics. So you can spend special amount of time in learning about this particular chapter. Then 2 days you will spend each time in learning about the formation of rocks and the various volcanoes and landforms and their formations. Days 182 and 183, you will be learning about the various geomorphic processes like earthquakes, cyclones, tsunamis and all. 3 days each in learning about pressure belts and wind systems, ocean currents. Separate videos already been made by SysBcrack exams regarding ocean currents. You can go through with that. 2 days in learning about important soil, afforestation, grasslands. 1 day each in learning about natural vegetation, renewable and non-renewable resources, biomes of the world, tribes and their migrational settlements, towns, megacities and projects. And then in the last 4 days, from day of 207 to 210, you will have the complete geography section revision. With this, you will have the complete analysis of the geography portion until now. Your next focus will be starting off in learning about the history section. Okay, while starting off with the history section, we can see that even in the recent year, the number of questions were actually pretty high. There were 22 questions in CDS 2 2020, which is one question less than the maximum number of questions that have been asked in CDS 2018 question paper. So going through with the pattern that is being proposed by this particular bar graphs that we can see here, we can say that we can expect from around 18 to 20 questions in the upcoming CDS examination, and answering all of them properly, you will be able to score 15 to 16.66 marks in the CDS examination. Going through the detailed study plan regarding the full study plan of the CDS, we are spending 3 days in completely learning about the ancient history, the early man and the life that he had completely led. 2 days completely learning about the Indus Valley civilization. While going through with the Indus Valley civilization, please spend ample amount of time regarding the various kinds of excavation sites and who discovered those sites, what are those sites famous for, and what are the various details that are being provided by the Indus Valley civilization. Going through, 1 day we'll learn about the completely regarding the Vedic society. While going through regarding Vedic society, learn about the different types of Vedas, who wrote those Vedas, what are those famous for at that time, what was happening, how was the society at that particular point of time in our country. So all the details regarding that. 2 days you will spend in learning about the Mauryan Empire, 1 day each in learning about Sangam literature and indigenous dynasties at that point of time. 2 days again spending time regarding Gupta period. While learning about Gupta period, spend specialized amount of time in learning about the Gupta architecture, their economy, and the way they have produced the first gold coins in our country. Okay, then going through on days of 223 and 224, you will be learning about the various dynasties of the medieval India. Going through in the next 3 days, we will have the complete knowledge about the Delhi Sultanate. While I'm telling, wherever you find about empire or sultanate and all, you need to have a complete knowledge about the complete chronology of the detailed analysis of the kings from the starting all the way from the first king on and up to the last king in that particular sultanate or empire. Then next, 1 day you will spend time in learning about Vijayanagar Empire, Mughal Empire, Carnatic Wars, Anglo-Maratha Wars, Anglo-Sikh Wars, stages of colonialism, drain theory, railways introduction, commercialization of agriculture, impact of Western education introduction. And then you will have 3 days of time in spending each time in learning about the rise of the social and religious reform movements, 1857 revolt, establishment of Indian National Congress, and then 1 day each in learning about moderates and extremists, economic nationalism, home rule movement, Khilafat and non-cooperation movements, civil disobedience movement, Quit India movement, and then 2 days in learning about Subhash Chandra Bose and Indian National Army. 1 day each in learning about the terms that are being mentioned all the way from the rise of Muslim League and all the way up towards everything regarding Indian Constitutional Assembly. 2 days in learning about industrialization and agrarian reforms after our country has been independent. And then thereafter you will learn about the policy of non-alignment, Panchil agreement with China, and then various other agreements that are being made with Pakistan. And then in the of 261 you will have the learning about the wars with Pakistan and also with the wars regarding the China. Then in the days of 262 and 263, we will learn about India and its participation in the United Nations organization. And the last 1 week, we will have the complete learning about the world history, wherein which you will be learning about the unification of Italy, Germany, American War of Independence, the wars between Russia and Japan, Russia and various other countries, and the various other important independence movements that are being taken up all across the world. With that, you will be completely finishing and learning about the section of the history part. And until now, what are those important subjects that we have completely covered? They will be physics, chemistry, biology, geography, and history. Okay. Once we finish history, it will be very easy for us to understand the topics of the Indian polity. My sincere suggestion, please spend as much amount of time that is being proposed here in the Indian polity. Okay. Because Indian polity is considered to be the most scoring subject in the complete GK question paper, and this subject is considered to be the most attempted subject by most of the aspirants, and these questions are very tricky, but still some of the questions are very easy. So please make sure that you answer these Indian polity related questions. If you see the recent question paper in CDS 2 2020, there were 18 questions, and the maximum number of questions have come up in both the times in the year of 2016, there were 23 questions from Indian polity. So by going through with this crucial study plan analysis regarding the Indian polity, number of previous years questions from the Indian polity in the CDS previous years question paper, so we can expect around 18 to 20 questions in the upcoming CDS examination, and answering all of them properly, you will be able to score 15 to 16.66 marks out of these 100 marks. Starting off with a study plan regarding Indian polity, we'll spend 3 days each of time in learning about our constitution assembly and the preamble of the Indian constitution, and then regarding the union and its territory, citizenship, 4 days in learning about fundamental rights, 3 days about BPS fees, again fundamental duties, and then 4 days again in learning about amending our constitution and how can it be amended and what sort of laws can be amended and all of those details. 3 days in learning about basic structure of the constitution, 3 days in learning about union executive, 3 days each in learning all the way up towards parliament and judiciary and all the way up towards those important topics which is the local bodies, and then 1 day you will spend complete time in learning about constitutional and non-constitutional bodies. Spend as much of time while learning about constitutional bodies because non-constitutional bodies is not very important, but still sometimes any kind of question might pop up, so we cannot take any risk regarding that, so you will also spend little amount of time in learning about the non-constitutional bodies also. In the last 6 days, you will have a complete revision and analysis of the complete miscellaneous and revision of all the topics of the Indian polity, and by this clearly you will understand about what are the acts, what are the important articles, the schedules, the parts regarding the Indian constitution, and how can one particular person approach, what are the different cases regarding that, and how is this particular subject very important for an aspirant, especially for the defense aspirant. Going through the next important subject will be about the subject of economics. Economics is also a very, very important subject. It was in CDS 1 2020. A whopping around 17 questions have come up in economics. Later on in CDS 2 2020, only 9 questions have come up. So we cannot say how many questions might come in economics in the upcoming CDS examination, but still, as a brief expected number, I can say that you can expect from around 10 to 12 questions in economics. So by answering all of them properly, you will be able to score 8.33 to 10 marks out of these 100 marks. Starting off with the study plan regarding economics, it is very simple. You will spend 4 days each in learning about the microeconomy and macroeconomy, 3 days in learning about the 5-year plans, 4 days again each in learning about taxation in our country, recent economic developments and the terms related towards inflation and various other economy. Okay, and then in the last 7 days, that means in the last 1 week, you will spend complete time in learning about the international organizations like International Monetary Fund and the World Bank and Asian Bank and all. The next subject that we are discussing is about the current affairs and the static general knowledge. So here, current affairs will be coming under the dynamic general knowledge and static GK will be coming under the static general knowledge. So combined analysis of the number of questions regarding both of these things, we can say that in the recent question paper, there were only 16 questions and the maximum number of questions have come up in CDS 2 2018, there were 27 questions. Which is very, very high in case of the CDS question paper. So going through with this particular previous year's question analysis, I can say that we can expect from around 18 to 20 questions in the upcoming CDS examination, and answering all of them properly, you will be able to score 15 to 16.66 marks out of these 100 marks in the upcoming CDS examination. Going through with the complete 1 hour wise analysis regarding day wise analysis of the current affairs and strategic section, you will start off with day of 361. That means we have finished all the way up to 360 days in learning the major important subjects. So from now you will be learning about the static GK related subjects and the current affairs related ones. So daily, without wasting any time, from the day, from the beginning of day one only, that means from the beginning of the subject of physics only, you need to spend your time a little bit, at least from around 15 to 20 minutes of time in completely knowing and noting down the important current affairs from that particular day. Okay, so going through with this particular plan, 2 days each will spend time in learning about superlatives of India and Indian space journey, important art forms, national institutions, national days of recognition, and countries, capitals, currencies, and languages. Then also you will learn, spend 2 days, 369, 370, 2 days will be completely in learning about three important topics, which will be superlatives of the world, international borders and important cities and their strategic locations. Then again, 3 days each in learning about the topics about the international days, which are recognized by the United Nations organization and various other international organizations, their headquarters and the current chiefs or director generals in all of these international organizations. Then from days of 374 to 376, you will learn about those important personalities that are related towards Bharat Ratna, Nobel Prize and Military Gallantry Awards. Then you will spend from days of 377 all the way from 382, 4 important topics you will be learning, which will be the important awards related to movies and books, and then the famous books and their authors and the famous newspapers and their chief editors. Then from days of 383, 384 and 385, 3 days we will be spending time in learning about the recent achievements related towards the subjects of economics, Asian Games, Commonwealth Games and Grand Slams and related topics. Then 2 days you will be spending time in learning about the various terms used in the sports while playing and also the various important trophies that are used while playing and then the famous notable sports persons. The last 3 days from days of 388 to 390, you will be having a complete static GK revision. Okay. So what happened until now, sir? I told you in a very clear cut way that in the beginning itself that this particular plan will be from around 400 days. So 390 days will be finished until now. So this will be the last 10 days. So our last 10 days, we will be learning about the defense specific related questions. So if we go through the previous year's analysis, we can say that we do not have a proper trend wherein which this defense specific is also a very clear cut important part. Okay, so if we go through the defense specific related previous year's analysis in the recent question paper in CDS 2 2020, there was only one question that was related towards this particular one, but in CDS 1 2020 there were 9 questions. Okay, so we clearly cannot say that how many number of questions are coming up, and but generally we can say if it is CDS 1 question paper then there will be maximum number of questions, and if it is CDS 2 question paper there will be less number of questions. So going through with the trend that is being shown up by this bar graphs of the defense specific subject, I can say that we can expect from around 8 to 10 questions, and answering all of them properly you will be able to score 6.66 to 8.33 marks, and which will be very very important ones in among all of these 100 marks. So if we go through the study plan regarding this important defense specific related ones, we will spend only 5 days in learning about the defense specific related questions. So 391, you will spend your time, the whole 1 hour you will be learning about the rank structure in all the three services and also the commands in all the three services. Day 392, you will learn about the military institutions and their establishments. 393 is regarding the famous technicalities regarding the aircraft of the Indian Air Force. 394 is regarding military deals, exercises, procurements, and then 395 you will be learning about the famous regiments of our army, squadrons of the Air Force and the naval warships. That's it regarding all of these important subjects. We have completely covered all the subjects, and from now on we'll have a complete final revisions and the mock test regarding this. Current affairs and the daily defense current affairs are to be followed on a daily basis, and then in the last 5 days you will be following and going through with the CDS mock tests that are being given up by CISBIC Rec exams, which will be like very 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 helpful in this examination point of view. So if you can see the complete detailed subject wise approximate percentage coverage of each and every particular subject wise analysis, we can say that from physics the number of questions will be 9%, chemistry 10%, biology 8%, history 15%, polity 15%, economics 8%, geography 16%, defense specific 4%, current affairs and strategy k 15%. Okay, so this is the percentage coverage of all of these subjects, and by going through with all of these important number of days from all the way from day from 1 to day 400, how are we following, sir? How many number of days are we allotting to each and every particular subject? So this is a complete study plan that we are following. We are spending 50 days of time in each studying about physics, chemistry and biology, and then we are spending 60 days, that means 10 days extra of time in learning about the topics of geography, history and polity, because these three subjects are very very important subjects. Then 30 days you will be spending in time in learning about economics. Again, the next 30 days is about the static GK. 5 days is enough for the subjects of the defense specific ones. And then in the last 5 days you will be going through with the mock test and the current affairs and the various other complete revision of the complete study plan that we have followed. On a daily basis, you will be going through with the current affairs, and the total number of days will be around 400. Okay, so that is it regarding all of these ones. You can also go through the days chronology on how to follow all of these important ones. So if you go through all of these in a very detailed way, here are the most important points that I want to keep in front of you to remember. First and foremost thing is always make sure that you maintain a separate dedicated notebook. Do not write here and there and then lose those important notes, because wherever you write, those are very very precious ones, and those only can be remembered very easily by your brain before or while the exam is being going on. And then in the next point I'm trying to tell you that the number of hours, if I say that you need to spend 1 hour of time in learning about some XYZ topic, then I clearly measuring you that that whole 1 hour is not just about listening the topic or listening the lecture. The whole 1 hour includes completing the lecture, writing the notes and also answering the quizzes or sample practice questions, however whatever things are available. Okay, and then always use maths that you get in your nearest stationery if in case you're going through with the geography part, because if you're using using maps in the geography section. It'll be very easy and handy for you. Always avoid the large numerical problems. Most probably you cannot expect any sort of numerical problems. All of these numerical problems will be related towards the formulas only. The more better you remember the formula, the more number of marks you will score in the physics section, and the various other sections, no, you cannot expect the number of questions from the other sections. Mostly going through in detail regarding these, all of these important points. And the last one I want to tell you, always once a topic is done, do keep all the notes towards yourself. If you feel that you're completely stressed out, gift yourself some time and go through somewhere and make yourself more refreshed, because the more better you think about yourself, the more free about you, about your mind, the more better you will be able to learn and grasp all these topics. Okay, and do not go through in learning about all of these other books that are available in the market. Only use SSB crack books or use NCERT books. Only these two books are most authentic ones, and these will be helpful in examination. Okay, you can always follow this particular plan, and if in case you want a change in this particular plan, or you have any other doubts or ambiguities, or you want to have a specialized session and you do want to have a talk with me separately, or any other subject matter expert of the SSB crack exams, and any other details and queries if you have regarding this particular study plans, you can always write to us at support@ssbcrackexams.com. Please remember this important email address, support@ssbcrackexams.com, and then you can share your complete thoughts and tell us about how important and helpful were these study plans for you. So that is it regarding all of this important session, and I hope that this session was very, very helpful for you. If in case there are any other doubts, please do not forget this particular email ID that I'm giving you here. Always stay safe, stay healthy, keep smiling, be confident. Jai Hind.